Welcome to the Sherwalls Online tutorial for the US edition. In this tutorial, we will go through the deflection, hold-on displacement, and story drift tables from the design results. For this video, we will refer to the same model used in previous tutorials of this series, with some details modification. The loads have already been generated, and the project file available in the description is saved until this point. Now on to the deflection analysis table. In this section, two types of deflection tables are available for the wind design: the MWFRS table, or main wind force resisting system, which is the deflection used to determine the shear wall stiffness for force distribution, and the serviceability table, which is used to determine the story drift. The drift limit for wind design can be set in the settings. For the MWFRS deflection table, the deflection is based on the basic wind speed input in low generation window. For the serviceability deflection table, the deflection is based on the serviceability wind speed input. Both tables present the same elements, so for the purpose of this video, we will go through the MWFRS deflection table. We first have the force direction, which is explained in video 5.3, shear results. The wall surface is either separated by its exterior and interior surface materials, or is grouped as both, when materials on both sides of the wall is the same. Notice that there is a feature to design both sides with the same material in the wall's input view. In the next column, we have the factored design shear force on wall segment, as well as the width of the wall segment and the associated heights. Now, depending on whether you choose the 3-term or 4-term deflection equation, information will vary. By selecting the 4-term deflection equation, the following terms are displayed: framing bending deflection, panel shear deflection, deflection from nail slip, and deflection due to hold down. The total deflection is then the summation of each component. If the 3-term is selected, the shear and nail slip components of the 4-term equation are combined into one shear component, and a section containing the apparent shear wall shear stiffness, GA, is reported, which is used to calculate that shear component. For more information about the difference between those two deflection equations, please refer to video 4.1, 3-term versus 4-term deflection equation. Note that for the seismic design, there is only one deflection table. The seismic forces is used for deflection, which is in turn used for shear wall stiffness calculation, are the same as those used for story drift check. The hold down deflection shown in the deflection table that we just looked at is unpacked here in the hold down displacement table and is separated by MWFRS and serviceability displacement information. After the hold down device column, the uplift force column indicates the accumulated hold-down tension force from overturning, dead, and wind uplift. The following columns show all the components that go into the calculation of the hold-down deflection, including the elongation of the hold-down, fastener slippage in the hold-down, wood shrinkage, and the wood crushing. Elongation includes the vertical displacement due to the manufacturer's published value for hold-down assembly for a specific anchor bolt length, and an added displacement if a longer anchor bolt length is used compared to the manufacturer's tested value. Notice that there is no value in the slippage column for this hold-down device, as most hold-downs are tested as assemblies rather than individual components, and therefore the slippage component is included in the elongation component in the listed deflection values from the manufacturer. The wood shrinkage component, shown next, is calculated based on the moisture content in fabrication and in service assigned in the design settings, as well as the length subject to shrinkage value entered in the structure block window, which is typically the depth of the floor joists at the top and bottom plates. The default fabrication and in service moisture content is based on that for lumber floor joists in a typical environment. If engineered floor joist is used or the environmental condition differs, the moisture inputs may need to be adjusted. Next is the wood crushing at the compression ends of wall segment, plus the extra displacement due to miscuts, which by default is set to 0.04 in the hold down settings. Finally, you have the total vertical displacement, dA, which is the sum of all the displacements we just described. This total dA is then multiplied by the aspect ratio of the segment in order to report the horizontal component due to the hold-down displacement. This matches the hold-down deflection component reported in the deflection results previously shown. It is worthwhile noting that the hold-down deflection on high aspect ratio shear wall segments, where the height-to-width ratio of the segment is larger than 2 but less than the maximum permitted ratio of 3.5, will be significantly more than the deflections of low aspect ratio shear wall segments. Once we have all the deflections for walls, story drift can be calculated based on the serviceability deflection values and compared to the maximum permitted drift. Here you can see actual maximum story drift taken from the worst case shear line on level 1 for each of the two principal directions. If deflections on a line have been equalized, therefore assuming a deflection-based distribution, it is the common deflection of all walls on the line. If using a capacity-based distribution assumption, it is the largest deflection among all of the segments on the line. Refer to video 3, Capacity versus Deflection, for more information on the different deflection assumptions. The allowable story drift comes from the wind design and is defaulted as equal as the story height divided by 500 and can be changed in the settings. The ratio reported in the last column shows whether the allowable story drift is acceptable, if less than 1.0, or not, if it's greater than 1.0. For the seismic design, additional information can be found in the story drift section. In fact, values regarding the maximum shear line deflection, maximum amplified shear line deflection, the deflection at center of mass, and amplified deflection at center of mass are tabulated in the actual story drift column. As for the next column, delta A represents the allowable story drift as per ASCE 7, table 12.12-1, followed by the story drift ratio measured at the critical shear line and the center of mass.